How good are your ratio skills for PSLE? Let's test them out with this math ratio question. Ben, Jimmy, and Sam each had some marbles. They each used the same number of marbles in a game. Ben used 1/3 of his marbles, Jimmy used 7/8 of his marbles, and Sam used 3/4 of his marbles. What was the ratio of the number of marbles Ben had at first to the number of marbles Jimmy had at first to the number of marbles Sam had at first? How would you go about solving such a problem? Since we know that the three boys each used the same number of marbles, let's start with the fractions that are supposed to represent the marbles that they used. Ben used 1/3 of his marbles. Let's draw that first. This fraction has a denominator of 3, so this means that if we were to draw a bar to represent all of Ben's marbles, we can divide it into 3 equal units. How many of these units did Ben use? Let's look at the numerator. Ben used 1 unit. What fraction of his marbles did Jimmy use? He used 7/8 of his marbles. How do you think we can draw that? The fraction 7/8 means that we are looking at 7 out of a total of 8 parts that represents Jimmy's marbles. Since we know that each of the boys used the same number of marbles, this means that 7 units of Jimmy's marbles must be as long as 1 unit of Ben's marbles. So let's draw a bar that is as long as 1 unit of Ben's marbles. Then, we'll divide it into 7 equal units. Once we know how big the 1 unit that represents Jimmy's marbles is, we can draw 1 more unit to this so that we have 8 units in all. This is 7/8 of Jimmy's marbles. Are we sure that our model is correct so far? Does 7/8 of Jimmy's marbles represent the same number of marbles as 1/3 of Ben's marbles? Yes, it does. So we're on the right track. Now that we've done the first 2 parts together, it's your turn to show your math power. How would you draw the model to represent Sam's marbles? Try pausing the video now to draw it first before checking back. Are you ready? Sam used 3/4 of his marbles. This means that he used 3 out of a total of 4 units, right? First, let's draw the part that should be as long as one of Ben's units. Here are 3 units. Then, how many units should Sam have in total? Yes, he should have 4 units. So let's draw 1 more unit for Sam. Now that we have our model, let's take a look at it and think about what we can tell. Ben's 1 unit, Jimmy's 7 units, and Sam's 3 units represent the same number of marbles. To make things easier, let's make these units the same size, okay? Here's where some P6 kids might make a mistake. If you compare this 1 unit and 7 units, you might think that it's easy to make 1 unit to 7 units by cutting this into 7 smaller parts. You're right. But, when it comes to making these 7 smaller parts and these 3 units the same, you'll need to cut the smaller units that we have into even smaller parts. You don't want to do that because it's going to be quite hard to count. Instead, let's use a shortcut. The key of this problem lies in us making these units equal. So instead of doing our working on our model, let's just make use of our fractions. Do you see that the numbers on top corresponds to the number of units that we want to make equal here? So the shortcut is to make the numerators of all these fractions the same. What's a common multiple that you can think of between 1, 7, and 3? I hope you said 21. And good job if you did. Let's find the equivalent fraction of each of these fractions with a numerator of 21. 1/3 is the same as 21 out of 63. 7/8 is the same as 21 out of 24. And 3/4 is the same as 21 out of 28. Do you know what these denominators stand for? Yes, these tells us the total number of units each boy has. And we've found that without drawing the units. Can you tell what is the ratio of the number of marbles Ben had at first to the number of marbles Jimmy had at first to the number of marbles Sam had at first now? How many units represent Ben's marbles altogether? Yes, 63. And what is the total number of units that represent Jimmy's marbles? 24. And finally, we have 28 units that represent all of Sam's marbles. So our answer should be 63 to 24 to 28. Can you solve this other ratio question with the same method?